There was some booze at the final whistle there. What were your thoughts on that as a fair?
I understand. When we play home or away, and you play Crystal Palace, we have to win. And with all respect, and I know every game in the Premier League is difficult, and you have to play your best. But I understand that the fans expecting a win, and we didn't win, and we lost.
Is your concern that your season is going to be like this, kind of up and down, a couple of wins, defeat,
Of course, is that the concern, and we have to be more consistent. And so this is not a demand for Man United. Demand is that we get a row of wins, and so get into a series. But we have to do better than we do now.
I know it's very difficult to gauge just about Henry, but do you know why it has been like this so far this season? Why it's been up and down? Is there any main reason you can give us why?
I can give you reasons, but it's you will explain it as an excuse, and there are no excuses. We have to win.
Is Marcus Rashford's form concern? He had such a good season last season. He only got one goal, came off today. The crowd seems to be lifted by the Garnacho as well.
Oh, I think he knows he can do better as he do now, and I'm sure it will come. He works hard, and that's what he's doing. He will finish, and it will come. But it's not going automatic. He has to invest a lot. The team has to invest a lot around him. As we have seen today, we were in the right positions, but then the decision making was not good enough, and then we don't score.
Steve.
Yeah, it's Eric. Another home defeat. This place, Old Trafford used to be a fortress. Are you a soft touch now, Old Trafford? Because lower teams who you just rightly alluded, United weren't expected to be, are coming here and winning.
Yeah.
Even a big team like Liverpool, City, Arsenal, Tottenham, you've got to come here this season.
We lost now two games in a row in the Premier League, clear. But I wouldn't set that conclusion now. But we have to do better. That is definitely the case. And we have to show it also in our body language that Old Trafford is a fortress. That you can't get anything here. And that the only way you can go away here is with a lose, with a loss. So, we have to do better.
You just mentioned body language, and I'm not necessarily going to suggest that Palace wanted it more, but each and every player really put in a shift today. Did you feel that you had the same from your team today?
I think that I can't blame the players for that they didn't run, and they gave, I think, everything. But so, in the final part, in the both boxes, we didn't do well. And we only conceded three chances, and the three chances were from set plays. So that tells me we were in control. We were often in the right position in the final part, but then, as I just explained, we didn't make the right decisions. In and off the ball. And that is, of course, very disappointing. And we have to be more clinical. We have to be more determined. So if you ask me that question, definitely. We have to be more determined if you want to score a goal. So you have to show more willingness and to get more impact and to score that goal.
Okay, last question at the back there.
Since we can't push the ball into the box, but United still make some chances. Is the problem of luck?
No, that's not a matter of luck. You can't explain it like this. That is, it's the form of the day. From the team, I think we get into the right spot, and then you have to make right decisions to create more. But even I think we created many occasions in front of the goal, and then you have to net. And yeah, we didn't do. And I think we only can blame ourselves.
Full time from Old Trafford then, where Manchester United have lost 1-0 against Crystal Palace in the Premier League. It marks Manchester United's fourth defeat in their opening seven matches of the new Premier League season. And it marks United's worst start to a new league campaign in 34 years. A real difficult one for United fans to digest today against a side who they, of course, defeated very comfortably in midweek. It was a week that started quite well for United. That victory away at Burnley, that home win against Crystal Palace, two good wins, two clean sheets, all undone. A backward step today against Crystal Palace, a Palace team who came here and did a job at United. They played really well, they stuck to their game plan. They took the lead for a good goal from Joachim Andersen in the first half, and United didn't really do too much to trouble them thereafter. At full-time, there were boos. Erik ten Hag was not happy with the officiating. United fans weren't happy with the officials and the referee either. They felt that there was a couple of possible penalty appeals. I'm sure there'll be other complaints that might, you know, find the light of day in the wake of the game. But ultimately, you can't be blaming the officials. You can't be blaming the referee for United's poor performance today. And it was a poor performance, or a collective of poor performances, really, because they were there from front to back, really. I mean, United were limited with what they could do. Of course, that defensive crisis has continued. United were without Sergio Reguilón and Lisandro Martinez, as well as those players who were already sidelined heading into the game. And then Sofyan Amrabat played at left-back. He's not a left back, he's a midfielder. That was abundantly clear today. He was good in possession of the ball, good at moving the ball, a good passing range, but he was exploited on the left. And playing with Marcus Rashford there, who didn't offer him too much protection, he was going to be exploited. And it was a poor foul given away by Amrabat that led to the free kick that gave Palace a lead. Casemiro was equally poor as well with some of his decision making, some of the fouls he gave away. Marcus Rashford, maybe the most disappointing of all the United players, still perhaps dining off last season's glory a little bit. You know, he hit an outrageous output and was genuinely world-class for United last season, Marcus Rashford. This season, he's just not quite got going yet. His decision-making's been poor. He's been a bit selfish at times. Maybe that does stem partly from the fact that he didn't maybe fully trust his fellow forwards last season and is still stuck in the habit of having Valverde up front rather than Rasmus Højlund. Højlund was okay, didn't really, you know, he had a good chance in the first half, but it was cleared off the line by Tyrick Mitchell. There were a few other sort of half chances that never really quite fell his way. Garnacho, a bright spark from the bench, he really gave United that drive and determination. But again, the problem with Garnacho is that he is much better as an impact substitute, but it comes at a time when Man United perhaps need him to start, because Facundo Pellistri was given that role on the right wing again today and ultimately was disappointing again. It's not to single him out. I know he's a young player and he's got a lot to learn still, but this is maybe a reality check again of where he's at in his development right now. United got so desperate towards the end that they threw Harry Maguire and Donny van de Beek on. They'd already brought on Eriksen and Marshall to try turn the game in their favour. It didn't work. United were furious that there were a few penalty decisions that didn't go their way. There were a few VAR checks that maybe were glanced over, not interrogated as much as they should have been, but ultimately United just didn't do enough. They might want to try and find someone to blame and scapegoat, but they need to take a good hard look at themselves, because it has not been good enough for Manchester United this season and this afternoon either. It was more of the same in all the worst possible ways. What next then? United against Galatasaray on Tuesday night, and that already has the makings of a very, very important Champions League tie. Of course, United lost against Bayern Munich in their opening match, and now they face Galatasaray here at Old Trafford again. It'll be a game that United are expected to win. They were expected to beat Crystal Palace as well. It doesn't always turn out that way. United will need a stark improvement, and yeah, their hands are tied to a degree. They will be hoping for some more positive injury news this week, potentially some players returning and giving Erik ten Hag more options to choose from, but you know, it's easier said than done. And ultimately, you can look at the two squads today. United should be winning that, even with their injuries. I know that they were without a number of key players, but that Man United team should be good enough. They made such a good habit last season of beating the smaller sides at home. Crystal Palace were one of those teams. They held on with 10 men last season to beat Palace here at Old Trafford. They couldn't do it with 11 today. They didn't deserve to win the game. A draw perhaps would have been a fairer result, but Palace did a job on them. They played well, defended resolutely. Yes, there were a few questionable refereeing decisions. Yes, Man United might feel that they were hard done by, but ultimately they've got to look in the mirror. Full time from Old Trafford, Manchester United 0, Crystal Palace 1, United's fourth defeat from 7 in the Premier League, their worst start to a new league season in 34 years.